What up, gang? And it's your boy Trev, man. And I come before you with a new video. I posted a questionnaire thing on my Instagram basically saying, what's some questions? Because this is going to be a Q&A. This is going to be a Q&A, y'all. This is going to be a Q&A. So I was like, why not? We reached 200 subscribers. So, but it's 200 subscribers. But y'all giving me 200 motherfuckers who fucking with me, I'm going to give y'all a couple questions. Yeah. I mean, I don't know if that equal out. For y'all being 200 people that juggle me, support me, you know, watch my videos, the ones that watch consistently, because it ain't 200. Let's start off with the first question. What is your first name? I think I've said my first name a couple times in my videos. I've said my first name a bunch of times. It's not really a secret. Like, my name is Trevor. Trevor. And yes, I am black. My name is Trevor and I am black. Shocking, huh? Yes, yes. Hey, I'm just saving up some time on the conversation that I've had too many times. I'm saving up some time, alright? Alright. My biggest insecurity. My biggest insecurity. Alright, I already know if it's an insecurity, but it's something I think about within myself. I think I walk weird. Look, nobody's ever called me out on it though. Like, nobody's ever been like, hey, that nigga Trevor walk weird. I mean, they might say like I might walk like this sometimes. So I watch that sometimes and I'm like, I'm not that big. But like, when I'm walking, sometimes if I think about it too hard, I feel like I'm like walking weird. So like, I'm very self-conscious of walking past like a group of girls or something like that. I mean, I hate to say a group of girls. Anybody, I'm very self-conscious about walking past a group of people because my biggest fear is fucking up my walk. Like, I'm like, what if I fuck up my walk? So as I walk past a group of people, I'm thinking about walking too much. So I'm just like, oh shit. All right, what if I fuck up my walk? Did I step with my left foot too many damn times? Oh shoot. Like, I be tripping, bruh. So, all right, next question. How many bodies? How many bodies? All right. All right. I didn't think I was gonna be able to tell y'all this. I mean, but damn, we all grown. I think it's all obvious. This type of information is like, it's become more prevalent. It's obvious, you know? So, I got one. Ain't it obvious? It's just one body. Do you know somebody with more than one body? I mean, I guess you can count twins, or I guess you can count like triplets, quadruplets. That's more than one body, because I mean, like, they all look the same. But you know, I'm just one body, dude. That's weird. You weird. Weirdo. That was weird. I should, like, don't ask me nothing like that no more. I knew what the f*** he was talking about. How old are you? I am 19. Y'all believe that? Y'all believe that? Y'all believe I'm 19? Alright, good, good, good. I need y'all to believe that. No, I'm just playing. Alright, nah. I am 26. I'm 26. Do you have any kids? I hate this nigga. Do I have any kids? I did have one son. His name was Blue. Man, I love Blue so much. Man, Blue, the way he used to, the way he used to get from one end of the tank to the next. That little blue stripe across his head. Man, that boy ate a lot. He was just like his daddy. He was a champ.
Boy, if you don't,
I miss you, Blue. Didn't nobody swim as fast as you, Blue. I love watching Blue swim. We bonded over Blue swimming. I remember the first day I dropped Blue in his tank. Oh, did I mention Blue is a fish? Blue died in June. R.I.P. Blue, man. R.I.P. Blue. I loved him like a son. Loved him like a son. He was my firstborn. How would you get over having to let someone go? Oh, man. You want to know something? I started reading this, and before I could stop, I just couldn't stop reading it. Because naturally, as humans, we're drawn to questions like this. How do you get over having to let someone go? Hey, bruh, if you going through this, I'm sorry for you, bruh, because I feel like I'm currently in the process of, I'm going to say letting someone go. If this is what you going through, bruh, I feel what you're talking about. Like, I feel what you're saying, man. Like, I know the pain you could possibly be feeling, because if you got to let someone go, at some point you had them. And to have somebody, it had to be in, like, kind of like an intimate manner. Intimate don't always mean sex, for those of you that don't know. Probably took them in, emotionally. You took them in emotionally. So, when you take someone in emotionally, some people, that's a hard thing to do, like, to take somebody in emotionally, especially if you have walls up. And we live in a world where it's kind of hard to trust people. So if you've taken someone in emotionally, which is something hard to do, that's a different type of love for a person. So when it's time to let that person go for something like, oh, y'all are going on separate paths, or they broke your heart too many times, or you're tired of breaking their heart, anything like that, like, that can be hard as hell. Like, that shit can be tough, because to love somebody is to connect with them on so many different levels spiritually. Like, if you gotta let somebody go, like, that's pretty much telling yourself that you have to be okay with not having them around as much. And, like, that don't sit, I can imagine that sitting right on anybody's heart. Me, personally, I'm kinda, I've had my trial and error with that, man. And learning how to deal with it, because no human has the perfect recipe to deal with that. And to sum it up, that's another form of heartbreak. The best way to deal with heartbreak, man, is to just keep moving forward. Don't stay in one place, man. Don't stay in that one spot sulking about having to let that person go, or your heart being broken over it. Don't allow yourself to be stagnant by heartbreak. Because time is not gonna stop. Time is still going on, and if you still sitting there, and two birthdays pass, and you still sulking over that, still ain't moved from that same spot, you're wasting your life. And life is meant to be lived. Live your life, man. Keep moving forward. Hey, that's one of the reasons why I fuck with Meet the Robinsons, man. Big shout out to them, bruh, because that saying, keep moving forward, that shit is real, bruh. You gotta keep moving. You gotta keep moving, because life ain't gonna stop for nobody. I'm learning that now. At my age, like, I'm learning that now. Like, life does not stop. Like, everything keeps going, and you have to figure out a way to keep up with the pace. And if not, you keeping up with the pace of life is in a way you control in life, because it's your life. So you're in control of your life. So if you can figure out a way to keep up with the pace of life, you're in control. You win, bro. Keep going, man. Keep going, man. Keep moving. If you got a dream, if you got a passion, any of that, you put all that emotion that you will put into that person, into that. Let it fuel you. If you, hey, I don't know what you do, nigga. I really don't. But if you do music, nigga, nigga, you better be dropping the best fucking love songs ever. If I don't hear your song, if I don't hear that nigga, what's the nigga to say? If I don't hear Incognito, for people that live in Cleveland, if I don't hear Incognito or anybody on the radio talking about your song, if I don't hear your song reposted, nigga, it's a problem. If I don't hear your song and think, damn, I want to clap some cheeks, man, let me turn this up. And hey, everybody know every good love song got a Everybody know that. It got somebody doing a little hey, whether you rapping or not. Even a little rap, the niggas that rap, they do auto-tune. They do the hey, like some shit like that. I don't know. But listen, fuel your passion. Fuel what makes you happy. Don't make people the base of your happiness. Let me repeat it. Don't make people the base of your happiness. Because if you do, you'll be disappointed every f***ing time. What are they here for? They're here to live their life. So if it comes down to them doing something to make you happy and make them happy, what do you think they're going to do? Duh. Like, dude, don't make, like, it's important, like, love people. But you have to, you gotta be happy with yourself. All right, let me quit preaching though. You get it, man. You get it. You know. Good talk. We reconvene in a couple months. Hit me up. Let me know how that go. Why you don't do a fitness channel? Nigga, you post workout videos more than you. Nigga, you post workout videos more than YouTube videos. Nigga, get a new max every week. Oh, you said nigga get a new max. I don't know. I've actually talked about that. I guess I wanted to grow a bigger following, but maybe I could get a following posting my workouts. What would y'all think of that if I started posting my workouts? Because I actually been thinking about doing it. Because, I mean, I go to the gym a good amount. And as much as I go to the gym, I probably can record what I'm doing. Like, because, I mean, people ask me questions anyway. Like, I mean, I'm not like the biggest dude. Hey, what can I say? I'm that nigga. Come on, with me. Come on, with me. I'm that nigga. What can I say? What can I say? What can I say? What can I say? So, be prepared to subscribe to my fitness. Well, actually, I'm gonna post a couple on here first. I'm gonna fill those out, see how y'all feel about those. See how y'all feel about these big ass gains. All right, have I ever been caught doing the nasty? I usually don't put myself in situations to get caught because, like me, I like to finish. I like to, like if I start it, I need to finish it. So nobody walking in is about to stop that shit. Like, nobody's about to stop me from finishing that job. That plate I just fixed, I need to finish eating. I ain't getting up from the table till I'm done eating, basically, is what I'm saying, slime. So if somebody walking in on me, I ain't stopping. So since I know I ain't stopping and that would make somebody uncomfortable, I'm not even gonna put myself in that situation. Now, I've had it where a girl's parents have came home and I've had to jump out a window. I made a video on that right there. Watch that shit. Real talk. It got crazy. Name three unbeatable movies. Three unbeatable movies. Hobbs and Shaw. That's my favorite movie right now. It's just because, right, my favorite actor/bodybuilder is The Rock. Like, The Rock, that nigga the GOAT to me. In that movie, that nigga the GOAT. And plus, I like when Idris Elba was like, I'm not black Superman. Or did he say, I'm not black Batman? He said one of the two. I think it was black Superman.
Look at me. I'm black Superman.
Oh, shit. Which one has to die? All your family members over the age of 35 or all your family members under 35? Yo, this is dark as hell, bruh. This shit is dark. 35 or under all my family. Bro, where do you get a question like this from, nigga? Like, you really have to think about this. I'm gonna say under 35 just for the simple fact a lot of my family just entered their 40s. So if I get all the ones that's like over 35, I just killed my whole damn family and I don't want to do that. So I'm gonna do under because there's less people under. Wait, no, that means I gotta go. Nah, we're gonna go ahead and get the ones that's over 35. We it's okay. Y'all taught us enough. We gonna carry out the name in an honorable manner. I'm sorry. I love y'all. We love y'all to death, but I don't know. I'm not answering this. I don't want nobody to go. I'm a sentimental nigga when I gotta be. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. No. Come back. Bring your eyes back here. Oh, I forgot to say it. Y'all better remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Alright? We're up to 300 now, nigga. Let's go. Alright, y'all. We went down to the last two. Why you so fine? Hey girl, don't play. Don't say nothing you can't take back. I'm playing. I don't know. Ask my dad or my mom, man. I ain't nothing though, man. I'm just a regular nigga. On G-Ma, who's your favorite cousin? It better be me. Yeah, it's you. You're my favorite cousin. You're my favorite cousin for sure. That on G-Ma. All right. Who are your favorite people? It's crazy because, like, as I've grown older, I kind of feel that feeling that people said, that I would hear older people say when they say I don't like people. I don't like people. People are fucking terrible. But I love some people. Like, some people is messed up. But, okay, let me quit playing. My favorite people would have to be my family. Because I think the reason my favorite people is my family, and it's some friends included in this too, because some friends I look at them like family. I mean, naturally you should, as you get older, like friends not being friends, like some of them, like they become family. But my family means a lot to me. That's like my number one thing, because I love family gatherings. Like on holidays, I think all family should be together, because I got a feel of that when I was younger. And like, kind of stopped as I started getting older. And like, as I started getting older, that's when I wanted to pick up even more, because I'm older now. You know, I could be a part of the grown-up conversations now. I can sit at the grown-up table now. I ain't gotta go in the basement with the kids no more. I ain't gotta sit at the little colorful table no more. I can drink with y'all even though I don't want to drink. Like, it's a pass the torch moment, man. We all grow together and everything, man. But that's why I like my family, because I feel like your family, they're the ones who kind of know you the best, or they should know you the best. And spending time laughing, loving, all that with people that know you the best, that should be the most comfortable, and that should be the funnest. And my family is like, family is everything to me. We don't always see things either, eye to eye, but they're everything to me. From my brothers, to my sisters, to my cousins, my dad, grandma. I miss anybody? Cousins, aunts, uncles. Like, if I could bring everybody together for one sunny ass day, oh yeah, on God, you better believe I'm making it happen. We're making a whole goddamn street shake on G-Ma. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Oh, whoa, no, come back. Bring your ass back here. Nah, I forgot to say it. Y'all better remember to like, comment, and subscribe. All right? Bro, 300 now, nigga. Let's go.